nimeingia tena na leo hii basi naja nikiwa na ndimi, nikiwa na homa, yani nikiwa na baridi kali kali. Hujambo na karibu sana ndani ya hashtag chaumbea 254, na tumai kwamba uko salama salmini. Na sasa hivi leo nitakuwa nikiupeleka moja kwa moja hadi pale kwenye afisi za nini, za mswada wa fedha, na nitakuwa nikimzungumzia basi mwenyekiti wa mswada wa fedha, so mwingine Francis Kimani. Mnajua kwamba basi tumekuwa tunapigana sisi kama wako wa Kenya kuhusu swala la finance bill, na isitoshe pia tumekuwa tunapigana sana dhidi ya kupandishwa kwa ushuru hapa nchini Kenya. Na mkikumbuka pale kwenye interview ya mheshimiwa rais, kidogo aliweza kuhojiwa pale na akasema kwamba baada ya yeye kuweza kuepukia kiti chake cha urais mwaka 2027, atahakikisha kwamba ameweza kupandisha ushuru mpaka ikaweza kufika takriban 24%. Leo hii mpendwa mtazamaji, baada ya wiki kadhaa za kuwa tunapigana pigana pale kuhusu finance bill, basi mpendwa mtazamaji, habari sasa hivi ambazo zimeweza kutufikia ni kwamba Francis Kimani ameweza kutangaza kuwa basi VAT ama basi ushuru uliokuwa umeongezwa, asilimia ya ushuru iliyokuwa ikiongezwa pale kwenye mkate. Mnafahamu mkate wa kinywaji kinywa asubuhi eh? Yes, mkate umeweza kushushwa. Wakenya mpendwa mtazamaji, yani nakwambia Wakenya hamchelewi eh? Wakenya hatuchelewi. Tumefika pale kwenye posti mpendwa mtazamaji, tumeanza kusema eh, wametuletea swala la kuangusha mkate ndo angalau tuweze kusahau na finance bill. Yes, Kenyans are angry my friend. Kenyans are totally angry. Okay, nitakwenda kusomea baadhi ya comment ambazo ziko pale kwenye mitandao, ambapo tunaona Wakenya wameweza kujitokeza na kufungua kufungua basi mioyo yao dhidi ya swala lile ambalo limeweza kutangazwa pale na Francis Kimani. Na pia mmoja wapo ya mambo ambayo yameweza kutajwa pale yalikuwa ni kuwa mama mboga hata kuwa akibasi akiwa anakatwa asilimia ya huduma za M-Pesa. Wa Kenya. Yes, najaribu kutafuta hiyo screenshot ambayo nilikuwa nimekupigia. Aha, nimekwisha ipata. Okay, mpendwa mtazamaji, baada ya basi ya matangazo yale ambayo yameweza kutupata pale, tumeona Wakenya wakiingia pale, na mpendwa mtazamaji nakwambia kuna moto, yani kuna waka. Na hivi ndio mmoja aliweza kusema, pure stupidity. They know very well that the finance bill document is bigger than what they are saying. Devolution has started. Mwingine akasema reject the finance bill, not amend. Mwingine akasema address everything and even after finish your term and leave us alone. I say angry Kenyans, angry Kenyans. Twendeni tuwadanganye tumepunguza bei ya mkate ndio waachane na finance bill. Still hashtag reject finance bill 2024. Na mkikumbuka pale ni moja hapo ya hashtag ambayo imekuwa ikisambaa sana kwenye mtandao wa Twitter, hashtag reject finance bill hapa nchini Kenya. Anywho, ilikuwepo ni baadhi tu ya comment ambazo ziko pale. Mwingine pia akasema this is just a PR strategy, guys, don't be fooled. Mwingine pia akasema you cannot create a problem and assume the savior position out of it. Kenyans finya finya kabisa, dropping 1 shilling too and add 5 shillings elsewhere. No majoka, majoka no. Hii hesabu ya kutia na kutoa sio hapa, jaribu Kongo. Wa! Okay, mimi sijui maoni yako ni yapi. Nitakuwa nakupa video ambayo itakuwa inazungumza pale, uweze kuniambia je, maoni yako ni yapi, na uniambie unaona kwamba ni jambo la kuwa wanazingatia sana masuala la mikate, hivi ni vitu vidogo vidogo au sio vitu vidogo vidogo kulingana na Wakenya wanavyozungumza.
And our prime cabinet secretary, on behalf of the executive, we have had a very robust engagement the whole morning from 7 a.m. this morning, reviewing the finance bill of 2024-2025 that was submitted to the National Assembly for consideration by the Finance and National Planning Committee, which has since had a very robust engagement with Kenyans. We, as the National Assembly, through our parliamentary committee, we have listened to Kenyans through that robust public engagement as stipulated by our constitution in the form of public participation. And we take this opportunity to tell the country that we have listened to you. We have heard you. And the committee has briefed the parliamentary group on the proposed changes that they have proposed to the finance bill of 2024-2025 that capture many of the issues that were raised by stakeholders during the public participation, and we have been able to engage on all those and agreed with the executive under the able leadership of His Excellency the President. I will now invite our chair, the very able chair of our Finance and National Planning Committee, the member for Molo constituency in Nakuru County, the Honorable Kuria Kimani, to take us through the brief of what has been agreed on the changes proposed. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Leader of Majority, Your Excellency the President, and all Kenyans watching us this morning. When we started the public participation in the finance bill of 2024, we did make a promise that that public participation would not be an exercise in futility. We have listened to the view of Kenyans, and we are all in agreement that there are two things that we must do. One of them is that we need to protect Kenyans from increased cost of living, and therefore the proposed 16% VAT on bread has been dropped. To support, again, on reducing the cost of living, we are doing something about vegetable oil so that we do not make it expensive for Kenyans. Transfer of mobile services is a key concern to many Kenyans, and therefore, again, we have proposed that we do not have any increase on taxation or mobile phone transfer. We have seen in the recent past the proposals that you've made on statutory deductions on SHIF and housing levy has added a loan on especially on salaried Kenyans, and therefore we have proposed that those statutory deductions now be allowable to pay, so they will not pay an additional pay on those. We all agree that environment conservation is a key concern. The fact that you've had a drought and a few months of floods and our drainage clogs, we have agreed that we need to make a good decision about how to protect our environment. And that is what the wisdom on the introduction of eco levy. However, imposing this on locally manufactured goods would again increase the cost of those locally manufactured goods in the country and stand a risk of making them not competitive in the East African market and globally. Therefore, this eco levy will only be chargeable to imported finished products. And therefore, all locally manufactured items, and especially including diapers and sanitary towels, will not be subject to eco levy. We must make sure that we become a manufacturing country and not a trading country. And therefore, the imposition of this only on imported finished products makes our locally manufactured products more marketable to the, not just reducing the price, but also making them affordable to even export. On the VAT threshold, we have proposed in our amended report to increase that VAT threshold from 5 million shillings to 8 million shillings. Therefore, small and medium enterprises that have turnover of less than 8 million shillings do not therefore have to register for VAT. On ITIMS, we have had avocado farmers being asked to give ITIMS receipts. We've had mama mbogas who do their supplies to hotels being asked to register for ITIMS. We have proposed that these people be given exemption on ITIMS registration, and the and especially for those farmers and those small businesses that have a turnover of below 1 million shillings. We have had the conversation about eggs and onions and potatoes. So what you've done to protect our poultry farmers, our potato farmers in Nyandarua and Molo, and protect our onion farmers, we have proposed excise duty only on imported table eggs, imported onions, and imported potatoes. This makes our onions, our eggs, and our potatoes more marketable to us and the region. To support the fight against illicit brews in the country, we have proposed a change in excise duty to changing it from a volume to alcohol content. Therefore, those alcohol manufacturers that are producing alcohol very high content will now be required to pay higher duty because based on the alcohol content and those making alcohol of lower content now will pay less duty. To support our pension contributions, because one day we'll all retire, we are now increasing the amount of taxable pensions from, we are now increasing the amount allowable for tax exemption for pension contributions from 20,000 shillings to 30,000 shillings. So this is a big win for our pensioners. So we are moving our pension schemes to exempt. It is exempt at contribution and exempt when you receive your pension from 20,000 to 30,000. Yes, a month, per month. It's important to say this, per month. We have also been appraised of the money that is allocated for junior secondary school to hire all the intern teachers into permanent and pensionable terms. And the number there is actually 46,000 shillings, 46,000 junior secondary school teachers, in addition to recruit an additional 20,000. Your Excellency, we are very happy that the proposals that were brought to the National Assembly and the ones that we are proposing to the House are two amended documents. Because again, I repeat, the exercise we did on public participation was not an exercise.
Kama ulivyotazama mpendwa mtazamaji, hivyo ndivyo mambo yamekuwa. Sitakuwa nikizungumza mengi sana. Karibu sana, najua nimepotea, lakini du, usijali, manake nimeweza kurejea, nimerejea na nipo kabisa. Gonga notification bell, hakikisha umeweza kusubscribe. Niite Winnie Mandy na karibu sana ndani ya hashtag Chaombea254.